Hello everyone, this is Danny Segura and I'm joined by Jessica Aguilar via Skype, and she'll be defending her belt at World Series of Fighting 15 against Kalindra Faria. Jessica, how are you?
I'm doing good, Danny. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing well. Jessica, the last time I interviewed you was at World Series of Fighting 8, where you obtained your belt from World Series. How much has changed since?
Well, you know, I have a belt to back my ranking up now. I've defended it once, and everything is good. I'm blessed. I'm happy, healthy, thank God. I'm just doing what I love to do, so everything is going well. My preparation for this Saturday is going great for November 15th, WSOF 15th, so I can't complain.
Now, a lot of people were talking about you not fighting top level fighters. Obviously, the UFC has taken up most of the top 115ers, but you know, Kalindra, she is I've seen her previous fights, and she's definitely a top fighter. This is a tough test for you. How are you preparing for this fight?
So, as you said, she has a great record. She's, on the top 10 she's top 10 ranked in the world. She's on an 11 win streak. She's on an 11 win streak. She's a great stand up. She has, finishes by KO, and she has finishes in submission. So she's very, very well rounded. Mm-hmm. I've been training like always, Denny. I kind of focus on myself and train specifically for her, focus on what I need to get better at, but specific, So my sparring partners are imitating her style.
Now, I was watching some of your video blogs that you do, and it seemed you sort of had a nose problem. There was a couple of times you checked on your nose, and I know you've had a broken nose before. What's the situation with that? Is there an issue with your nose?
Yeah, Danny, thank you. It's been broken before, and during the training camp, I was headbutted. It was by accident, and it's just broken, but it's okay. It's healing, and it'll be ready for Saturday.
Does that bother you? I mean, what's the current state of it? Are you training and it just pops out, or what's the deal with that?
Yeah, it moves. I've been for these past 2 weeks. I was training, and it was an accidental headbutt. Mm-hmm. And it broke, and it just started bleeding. And I bleed really easily out of my nose since my nose has been broken before. But right now, I had these past 2 weeks, I've been wearing a different face gear, to protect my nose, so it hasn't been touched. And it'll be okay for Saturday. But yeah, it's really sensitive, but it can take a few punches.
So, it's going to be a big night, November 15th for MMA. You have Bellator, World Series, and the UFC. It seems that the fans are split between what event to watch. And obviously, this is a big fight for you. Do you feel like those two events might overshadow this big fight for you?
Well, I think it's great. It just shows that the sport is growing. And all the cards that we're going to be seeing November 15th are really great cards. UFC, it's going to be in Mexico, my hometown. Also the Bellator card that I have my fellow teammates fighting on. It's a stacked card as well. Mm-hmm. And then with mine, I think that, you can still record and rewatch. So, I really don't focus on that. I really don't focus on things like that. I have to be focused on being mentally prepared to win my fight. So, I wish everybody luck, and I'm just happy to see the growth in the sport.
Now, I know Ariel Helwani touched a little bit on this on his interview with you, but obviously the UFC has now the strawweight division, and they're having a tough 20, and they're sort of already claiming a number one spot. Whoever wins that title is going to be number one in the world, according to the UFC. But for the hardcore MMA fans that have been tuning in for a while, they know that you are number one. Does that bother you that maybe the casual fan will see somebody else as is portrayed as number one as opposed to, you?
It doesn't bother me, Danny. Because eventually, I mean, I'm gonna prove why, you know, I am the number one in the world. I want to continue fighting the best, and I'm just gonna keep doing what I need to be doing, which is training and winning my fights, and eventually, you know, like you said, the normal fan is gonna know who the number one strawweight in the world is.
Now, you say eventually. Does that mean maybe we'll see you in the future in the UFC?
You never know, Danny. You know, right now, obviously, you've heard me, and I say this a lot. I'm really happy with the WSOF, with mm-hmm. the opportunity that they've given me. And like I said, I just want to continue fighting the best. And, you know, if that's what happens, that's what happens. But I'm going to continue being the number one strawweight in the world.
So what can your fans expect on November 15th?
Another victory, man. You know, the belt's going to stay with me for a long time. It's going to be hard to take that away from me. You know, I prepare myself very hard. I take my job very seriously. And, you know, it took me a lot of hard work to get here, and it's going to take someone a lot of hard work to take this away from me. So my fans can expect a, you know, action-packed fight on November 15th, WSO 15th, and I'll defend my title.
All right, Jessica, well, best of luck in your fight, and thank you so much for the interview.
Thank you, Danny.